number 2 seed in Division 2 is taking on West Ranch. West Ranch during the week defeated San Marcos to get to play in this game. They're the 4th place team in their league, and they struggled towards the end of the season, going 2-4-1 in their last 7 games. What did Chino Hills do in their last 7 games? Just win every one of them. 6-1, the only loss to Claremont. They scored 30 goals in league and only allowed 3 goals during that 10-game stretch. 2 by Claremont and 1 to St. Lucie's. The question is, can they get up for this team? And can they continue their run through the playoffs that will see them culminate in 2 weeks in the championship game to be announced? We'll show you the highlights. We'll show you the interviews. Win or go home, it's the CIF playoffs from Chino Hills, California.
In this game, Chino Hills would be on the attack for most of it. This play right here, inside to Ashley Gonzalez. She turns, takes a shot. The goalkeeper, Matamedi, making the save. A little bit later, Alyssa Carthen having a couple whacks at it. Over to Dana Garcia. Another save by Matamedi. Then a through ball into Ashley Gonzalez. She goes one-on-one. Matamedi with another save. The next couple of chances, there's a block by the defense. Gonzalez would go down, injured. She would stay back on. A little bit later, Dana Garcia with the corner kick. Alyssa Carthen, far post, goal. No. Disallowed. Referee called pushing. I didn't see it. He saw it. He called it. No goal. West Ranch would have limited opportunities. And right here on the counterattack, they get a little break. But a great play on defense by Emily Sanchez to help break this up. Ball goes over the top of the bar. Still 0-0, second half action. Throw in for West Ranch, comes in across. A collision between two players, no foul. The ball would bounce around inside the Chino Hills defense, and Ricky Ives would make the save to keep it at a scoreless draw. But about 70 minutes in, Amanda Ball plays a through ball to Ashley Gonzalez. She gets behind the defense. She would capitalize with the first goal of the game. Here's another look at it. Starts with Dana Garcia out of the back. Over to Amanda Ball. She plays it through. Gonzalez beats two defenders and puts the ball into the back of the net. Chino Hills would look as though that they were going to wrap this game up. It was 1-0, and with their defense only allowing 3 goals in league, putting up a lot of shutouts, you would think that that would be enough for the Huskies to capitalize. The celebration dance by Amanda Ball and Ashley Gonzalez. And everybody was having a good time a little bit later. Gonzalez with another chance, just missing. Could have been 2-0 at that point. Then Alexa Oriente. One-on-one, she elects to pass it. Ball gets stopped by the goalie. Amanda Ball kicks it in the net, but the referee ruled that the goalie had the ball. No goal. Still 1-0. Then a long throw by West Ranch right through the goal. And on the far post, if you watch, that's number 13 that's going to come into your view. Scoring for West Ranch. They tie the game up. 1-1. Overtime we go into. In the first overtime, Ashley Gonzalez with a chance. She's going to go in. Beats one defender there. Holds the other defender off. Takes a shot. Matamedi makes the save. 1-1. Second overtime. Ashley Gonzalez, long throw. The ball bounces in front of the goal. Off the goalie. Cleared by the defense. That means we're going into penalty kicks. Referee tosses the coin. West Ranch wins the toss. They elect to shoot first. First kicker, the goal scorer, Jesse Holland. Saved by Ricky Ives. She knew it. Tough way to go. Ashley Gonzalez, the first kicker for Chino Hills. Head to Long Beach State next year. She capitalizes just right by Matamedi. Chino Hills has a 1-0 lead after the first round of kicks. Next kicker up, Nicolette Marinello. And she will convert for West Ranch, giving them their first goal in the shootout. Ties it at 1-1. Up next for Chino Hills, Amanda Ball, headed to Santa Barbara next year. She puts it in the right corner. Chino Hills up 2-1 after two rounds of kicks. Going to the third round. Number 33, Gianna Crimi for West Ranch. Converts just off of the hands of Ricky Ives. Two goals for Chino Hills, two goals for West Ranch. Chino Hills with their third kicker, Alexa Orancha. Oriente scores on that one right there. Chino Hills up 3-2 after three rounds of kicks. West Ranch, number 22, Sydney Caracolio, misses. That would mean Dana Garcia is going to step up with a chance to win the game if she makes it. And she does. Chino Hills wins on penalty kicks 4-2. They get a final score of 2-1. They advance to the next round in CIF playoffs, where they will meet Troy High School, and they will be on the road.
Number two seeded Huskies get by in penalty kicks, winning 2-1, 4-2 in the shootout. We talked to their head coach, Andy Placentia.
Close game, kind of what you didn't want this early in the draw, but how does it work positively in your favor, only winning this game in penalty kick?
It gives us a huge wake-up call, which is exactly what we need. I think from here on, I'm excited to see how they respond. They always respond in a good way. It was very scary, like you said. My voice is gone and shot, but you can never be mad after you lose. The whole point of today was to move on to the next round. We accomplished it. We have a lot of things to get better at, and we definitely will.
I thought the finishing was really off for you guys. You had so many chances in the game. Talk about what you guys need to do and why you need to finish those chances.
Yeah, it's great that they're creating chances, but obviously the composure's got to get better. We'll do it in training. We'll add some different pressure, some different consequences if we don't score a certain amount of goals in a certain amount of time, but we have to be more composed. The ideas have to be better. We can't just go up there and kick, for lack of a better term, kick the crap out of the ball and hope that it goes in.
Penalty kicks are not new to you guys. You won a tournament and you had a couple of times. I don't know how many times they've been in penalty kicks, but how important is that to make them all like you did today, especially going into the final rounds of CIF?
Yeah, my job is to prepare them for the worst case scenario. That was obviously the worst case scenario. They were well prepared. Obviously the players did a great job finishing it. So credit goes to them for finding a way to win after a performance that wasn't up to what we've done lately. But great teams always find a way to win, so I'm proud of them.
Well, congratulations.
West Ranch falls in penalty kicks tonight. They lose 2-1, 4-2 in the shootout. We talked to their coach, Jared White.
To see the team in this division, how much did your team surprise you when you played against this team? Or did they surprise you?
You know, we knew that we were going to have to put up a really good effort in terms of defensively staying organized, winning the 50-50s, not getting too down on ourselves when they took over momentum. Whenever you play an offensive team, they're going to get their opportunities. We wanted to make sure they were hard opportunities as opposed to easy ones. I thought we did a really good job of that. Super proud of my team. I knew if we played up to our capabilities, we were going to be able to be in it. But they've exceeded every expectation I've ever had for them, and I'm super proud.
Playing tough defense and stopping them in goal tonight was Ricky Ives. She's headed to Cal Poly Pomona next year. We talked to her right after.
This is a familiar spot for you, in goal for penalty kicks. Talk about what you were thinking before this all started.
We just were playing our game, like, coming out, like, after that first half, like, I felt a little something was off. Like, I have full confidence in my team, and I know that we're going to do what we can. But, like, we just weren't clicking. Like, West Ranch did a great job of shutting us down, getting compact. And I had, and then when the ref put us to PKs, I had full confidence that my team was going to make them. It was a lot of pressure on me to, like, step up and do what I had to do. But I'm beyond proud of them.
Ashley Gonzalez scored a goal in regulation, the only one the Huskies got tonight. And she also scored on a penalty kick in the shootout. We talked to her right after the
Ashley. You scored one goal today, but, that was enough to get that tie. What did you guys need to do to get more goals out there today? You guys just couldn't score, it seemed.
We just needed composure. As a team, we have it. We have everything we need to win this game. And it was probably not there certain times for us that we couldn't really get that goal in or have that last push in. But in the end, we did get the result we wanted.
Let's talk about the penalty kicks. What are you thinking when you step up to that ball?
I'm just really nervous, but I know I have to get in the back of the net, so I just stay composed, as my team told me, and as we worked on and stuff, so just composure.
So for the next round, for the next game, what do you guys need to do to win that game?
We just need to practice hard, practice as we've been practicing before, and just pick it up and just work as a team and talk about all of our mistakes and just fix them and polish up our whatever we need to polish up.
Good luck in the
Dana
next
Dana Garcia scored the clinching goal in penalty kicks. We talked to her right after the match.
So, Dana, you scored the goal that won the game for you guys in penalty kicks. What were you thinking as you stepped up to that?
As I stepped up, the ref said to me, if you make this, you win. And that's what, like, motivated me to score that goal and having Ricky save those two.
What during the game, what were they doing defensively that was stopping you guys? What was giving you guys a problem?
I think they all stayed compact, the defense stayed compact, and we couldn't, like, get past them, and we tried our hardest to split them and stuff, but they did a good job defensively.
So you guys were, you know, the number two seeded team. You're playing against a team that's, you know, that barely qualified on a wild card. What did this game teach you guys for the next game?
Never underestimate anybody and always play your hardest.
Well, good luck in the next round.
Thank you.
So tonight in this first round match, it ends in the evening. West Ranch goes down. The qualifiers are out. They go home. They lose 2-1 in penalty kicks. Chino Hills, the number two seed, they move on to the next round. Chino Hills now improves their record to 24-2, while West Ranch, they end their season at 11-10-5. We'll have the pairings for you Sunday night. This is Tom Kiss reporting from Chino Hills High School on the Tribune Sports.